The main principle in structuring an operating system for a shared memory multiprocessor is to limit sharing kernel data structures, which both limits concurrency and increases contention. This principle finds additional corroboration in the Cori operating systems research that was done at MIT, which wants to involve the applications that run on top of the operating system to give hints to the kernel. So let's talk about some of the ideas in the Cori system that is built at MIT. The ideas are similar to what we saw in Tornado, namely, you want to reduce the amount of sharing. That's the key thing. If you reduce the amount of sharing, it allows for scaling. And one of the things that is in Cori system is this idea of address ranges in an application. And basically, this is similar to the region concept in Tornado. The region concept in Tornado is under the covers. The application doesn't know anything about it. It knows that an application has an address space, and the operating system decides that, well, this application has this address space, but the threads of this application are accessing different regions, and therefore, I'm going to partition this data structure, the global data structure called the page table, into regions, and that way, I can ensure that there is concurrency among the page fault service handling for the different regions that the operating system has to deal with. Similar idea, except here, the address ranges are exposed to the application. So in other words, a thread says that this is the region in which I'm going to operate. And if the kernel knows the address range in which a particular thread is going to operate in, then it can actually use that as a hint in saying, well, where do I want to run this thread? If a bunch of threads are touching the same address range, maybe you want to put it on the same processor. And these are the kinds of optimization that the operating system can do if this hint is provided by the application. Similarly, shares is another concept, and the idea here is that an application thread can say that here is a data structure, here is a system facility that I'm going to use, but I'm not going to share it with anybody. An example would be a file. A file, by definition, for a process, is an operating system entity. Once the process opens that file descriptor is a data structure that the operating system maintains. And now if you have multiple threads in the same application, all of the threads have access to that file descriptor. But if a thread of that application opens a file and it knows that it's not going to share that file with anybody else, it can communicate that intent through the shares mechanism. Through the shares mechanism, it can communicate that intent to the operating system, saying that here is a file that I've opened, but I'm not going to share it with anybody else. That hint is useful, once again, for the kernel to optimize shared data structures. And in particular, if you have a multi-core processor, and if I have threads of an application running on multiple cores, I don't have to worry about the consistency of that file descriptor across all these cores. That gives an opportunity for reducing the amount of work that the operating system has to do in managing shared data structures. Another facility that is there in Cori is dedicated cores. Here the idea is that if you have a multi-core, you have lots of cores, might as well dedicate some of the cores for kernel activity. And that way, we can confine the locality of kernel data structures to a few cores and not have to worry about moving data between the cores. So all of these techniques that are being proposed in the Cori system is really trying to attack the fundamental problem that there is a huge latency involved when you have to communicate across cores or when you have to communicate outside of the core into the memory subsystem and so on. And all of these facilities are trying to reduce the amount of inter-core communication and core-to-memory communication and so on and so forth.